Hey, what's up, everyone? This is your girl, Miss Sophia the Diva. I'm back here again to do a review of Love and Hip Hop Atlanta, winner take all. I know we are in season 8. I don't remember what the episode is. I think it's episode 18, but I know it's the season finale. Can you believe we have survived this long on a season that kind of has been a little bit on struggle, but quite fascinating and crazy and all kinds of madness, especially since they brought poo-poo-poo to the show. Rashida said, hell, after the shitty sheet incident, she trying to remove shit from her vocabulary altogether. Okay, that's the one curse word she's trying to remove. So this episode, for some reason, was called Winner Takes All, but I guess because it was a casino theme that Scrappy and Bambi had put together for the launch of their businesses. I like that a couple is trying to build together, but I was just like, in addition to Bambi, Spice is even having a hair and wig line. I'm like, so Bambi is shimmering bundles or hair, shimmer hair or something. And now Scrappy has a new single that he's putting out as well as a record label. I didn't even know he was still doing music. As many of us have observed, this is love and hip hop, but yet the music that they play are none of the people that are artists on the show. I don't understand why more Spice music isn't being played. Akbar V has a catalog of music that they could be playing. Who else? Trying to think, Stevie J could be doing some production. I mean, it's so many artists. Please, we don't want any Carly ever to do anything. Tokyo Vanity. I mean, you know, speaking of which, she was absent from this episode too, but I guess we kind of wrapped up her storyline last episode. So I'm thinking maybe Bambi and Candace can get together on this hair bundle thing, you know. So at this party that Bambi and Scrappy are putting on, Shekinah is there and she's talking to Kendra. And I forgot who else was in the conversation, but she was telling him about, Bambi. And she was telling them about how, you know, things went down, how Carly produced some piece of paper that said it was a lie detector test. And Kendra was like, where the heck did she get that from? And you do know you can fake a lie detector test, right? And I was like, well, Carly, hell, she might have downloaded a sample lie detector test and then put her name on it and said it was hers. I mean, that's the type of shit Carly Red do just for attention and sympathy. And Carly's just messy, but I'm glad that Shekinah took ownership of the part that she played in causing Carly to have this information that she disseminated from one ex and ex-wife to the next that got back to Kendra. Now, Bambi did say that, yeah, you do need to check these dudes sometimes, but at the same time, I really do believe that Jock loves Kendra and wants to be with her for the rest of his life, for the rest of their days. But she was telling Kendra about how Jock showed up at their shop and went apeshit. She was like, he really do love you, girl. And, you know, Kendra was saying, like, what I was hoping she would come to is the fact that, you know, I have to consider the source where all of this stuff is coming from. And that's right, because Carly's messy. And when Cena told you it came from Carly, that right there should have been dun, 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 dun. Red flag. Can't believe it. And we know that Jock has a pattern of behavior, but I really do feel as though he's trying to turn it around for you. Meanwhile, Scrappy is being weird. He's at the bar smoking a cigar, sipping on some whiskey, talking about he had to meditate because Rashida and Kirk is like, we don't need to be looking for you. So he's kind of, he had brought up casino before. And he was saying, you know, I feel bad that I haven't reached out. And I'm like, why would you, if this is truly your friend, why are you just now reflecting and realizing you should be talking to him? Or is this just for sympathy and empathy to create a storyline? Because what kind of friend are you? And then when they met up at a church, I didn't understand that concept. I was like, was Casino having a church meeting there? I mean, that didn't make any sense to me, but who am I to question it? Maybe they were trying to get right with God together right there. But, you know, Casino was like, I just can't believe. And I'm like, I don't believe this shit. I'm not buying it. I just find it really hard to believe that you wouldn't be looking out for your boy after y'all both almost died in a car crash. And that was just weird. And during your party, you decide to go off and meditate. Like, I'm just meditating. I'm just like, okay. Meanwhile, down to the studio, Akbar, who has dubbed herself the Queen of Atlanta. Ha ha ha! I love. That's right, girl. Speak it into existence. Speak that confidence over yourself. But no, if anything, your cousin Candy might be the queen of Atlanta. I was like, who said that? Who told you that? Who said that? Well, you know, positive thoughts, positive lives, speak it into existence. And by the way, we don't have a monarchy here in, who was it that said that? Was it James Caldwell or Alex Rogers saying we don't have a monarchy here? So, but okay, girl. So her and Pooh are in the studio. Shay Mack shows up, which I'm surprised that Shay and Pooh can be in the same room since Pooh tried to offer her a dildo at one point. Akbar shares with them that her and Spice are going to be working together on some music. And Pooh was like, well, you know, I really didn't get to know anybody in Trinidad because it was so much drama. And I'm just like, you brought the drama. You brought shitty leopard print sheets to the beach. Like, who does that? Who raised you? But I was glad Akbar straight up told her. She was like, you know what? You look a fool, okay? You really need to stop running around acting like that, Pooh, you know? And the thing about it is that Carly is not your friend anymore. You just have to take that L and move on, okay? Not everybody is in your life for a lifetime. There is a reason and a season for them. And when that season is over, you gotta let it go. It's dead. Oh, but I'm glad. I said it's damn shame. The biggest fool on the show is the one that had to break it down to you. And plus, Carly ain't even a friend to anyone anyway. Her loyalty lies in mess. And the thing is that you just gonna have to let her be. Because she don't know how to be a friend to her own damn self. Hell, she in a broke down, messed up relationship. And she don't know which way is up. Okay? Then they were talking about how the things happened at that Mother's Day brunch. But I'm like, you gaslit your daughter anyways to go off. So both you and Carly were wrong for that. Mimi and Ty. Ty and Mimi are together. And, you know, they're talking about Stevie J and this whole little incident. I'm just going to wrap this storyline up. Bottom line is this with Stevie J, Ty, and Mimi. Stevie J does not like Ty because she is a stud lesbian, I believe is the proper term. She's a stud. And number two, he won't admit it, but I really do think that he has a problem with women in relationships together. I kind of picked up on that. And that's why he stayed throwing shade. On top of that, you know, Ty decides that she's going to sneak off and confer with Stevie so that maybe they can get some sort of peace thing going. But she breaks it down and tells him that you're not even being a real father to Eva. And I kind of believe that. You know, how is it that you spent over 20-some years of your life owing hundreds of thousands of dollars, millions of dollars in child support? How is that possible? And you've had millions of dollars. Although I do know dealing with Puffy or P. Diddy or whatever his name is now, or dealing with Diddy, you might be robbed, you might be broke ass and be, you know, needed to file bankruptcy at some point. So they play a game of one-on-one, and if Ty wins, Stevie has to publicly apologize to her. And the whole time I felt like this thing was very badly staged because Ty kept smirking like she couldn't keep a straight face because it was like a joke. So I was like, maybe this is a setup too. I mean, we know it's scripted reality, but not necessarily scripted as in written, but some sort of direction is given. Meanwhile, Scrap De Leon is having a tasting of his seafood and things, and everyone's there hanging out. Even Shay Mack shows up. We learn that Kurt and Rashida are opening the Frost Bistro or having a soft opening. And Scrap De Leon is able to procure Shay Mack a seat at the table as far as being the DJ for the event. Kurt was like, well, you know, I wasn't at the event with Carly's engagement party when that mess went down. And Lord knows, I know what it's like to have second chances given to you. I was like in third and fourth and fifth, huh, Kurt? So I'm glad that Shay is being given opportunities again because what she did was wrong. And when she told Pooh she had apologized, Pooh told me, what you apologize for? Because the shit was foul and wrong. And I let you gaslight me and that should have never happened. At some point, Shekinah and Sierra end up meeting up and they still girls for life. You know, they were trying to say that what Shekinah said about Akbar's kids were inappropriate. And Akbar said that Sierra said something about her kids too. I'm like, oh, then see, y'all wouldn't be so sensitive about these kids if y'all were doing the right things by them and for them. Shit, Don't let nobody demean you and tell you how to raise your children, but you need to be making efforts and better efforts, I feel, instead of out here trying to fight and run the streets. You should be trying to raise these kids. One thing I can say is that I am glad that Shekinah is one cast member that can own her shit. I will say that. So Sierra at the, I think it was at the Frost Bistro opening. I don't know. This episode really was kind of, I don't know what it was. They could have, this could have been extra scenes as far as I'm concerned. But Sierra shares that she's done some digging on Pooh and that she's going to wait for the right moment to let it be unleashed. Sierra, let's be mature adults. Let that lady live and leave her alone. You wouldn't want nobody to do you like that Carly Red and try to pull that shit on people. When Hoseline was on there, she tried to pull that shit on people. Don't do that. That's tacky and it's crass and it's not ladylike. Just let that sleeping dog lie. In other words, don't be like Carly. Faith, Stevie, Mimi, and Ty have a set down. It's a disaster. I don't even know why they showed it. Next thing you know, Stevie out here calling everybody bitches and hoes. Him and Mimi damn near about to come to blows, and Faith had to get them the hell on out of there. I thought Faith would be a good mediator. I don't know what the hell that was. Shekinah got Kendra to show up at a masquerade party during the day. Everybody's got on masks, so Kendra don't recognize anybody. Jock shows up. He proposes. He puts a ring on the girl. Let's get married. Meet me at the altar in your white dress. We ain't getting no younger. We might as well do it. Hey! Anyway, he said his life would be complete with Kendra. I believe that. So all her family and friends are there. As it turns out, the mask come off. It was cute. I liked it. Whatever. We also see that Spice is selling wigs. Pooh has resolved that her friendship with Carly is over. They still have pictures. She still has a picture in the apartment. One of my followers was like, isn't that kind of creepy? I'm like, yeah, Carly must have had some good Pootang. Because, you know, Pooh was wanting that shit back. I was like, God damn, that must have been some good, good. My thing is, once you stop hearing from a person, let it go. Let it be. But I think that's all there was this episode of Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. Y'all, this reunion is going to be a hot ass mess. But that's all I've got. Again, be sure to join me for a Diva Disturb every Tuesday night on BFAM 109.6. This week's guest will be comedian Shaq D, and we'll be getting into some ghetto gospel and other disturbing topics. Again, if this is your first time here, be sure to subscribe to this channel. I am Miss Sophia the Diva, comedian and host extraordinaire, and I hope to see you guys on the radio commenting during my show, 9:30 p.m. to 11 p.m. every Tuesday night Eastern time. Chin up, buttercups, and stay fabulous.